Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hi folks, Leo the Wise here to provide information about a REDDCOIN article from Reddit called, REDDCOIN Antibiotic Nuke, Come and Feed. This is the second part of the video. Buying into the last point, women have little sympathy for weak men. Despite the fair sex bullshit you may be accustomed to hearing, a man is far more likely to assist a weak man financially or emotionally than a woman is. Women are more selfish than men are in matters of money and love. Man's love is expected to be sacrificial. Woman's isn't. Women love pragmatically and have no capacity to love unconditionally for romantic partners. Only their children. Men can love women unconditionally. There is a hierarchy of love. Men, women, children. Women have a pronounced gender group bias, which means they typically de facto side with other women in a conflict regardless of logic or argument. Women are herd-like and stick together closely. They form cartels and use the power of the group to henpeck destroy enemies. Women have a sexual plurality. If you are a nice guy with money, you are husband material that can nail her after 12 dates and she's had so many glasses of wine she forgets how on a primal level you're not that attractive, just cute. If you are an asshole with nice muscles, you're the guy who gets to nail her after 2 hours of meeting. We call this sexual plurality in rather rhythmic slang, alpha fucks. Beta bucks. Women do not care about male weakness and neither does society. If you are weak, depressed, small, poor, uneducated, unconfident, not powerful, then nobody cares. People only care about you when you're powerful or a pretty woman. You have to pull yourself up by the bootstraps because nobody gives a fuck about you. Society will always have a safety net for women. White knights will charge in. The state will provide and etc. As a man, you have no such luxury. Your propensity and ability to gain power is much higher than a woman's, but your ability to hit rock bottom is far more pronounced too. As men, we are more extreme than women. Women are typically average and don't move much either side of the bell curve. As men, we are either highly successful geniuses of repute that feminists can but scoff and be jealous of, the poster boys for their esteemed patriarchy, or the ignored voiceless poverty-stricken peasant class that nobody gives a flying fuck about. The law prioritizes female safety and well-being over logic, honor and justice. Family law has been corrupted and is now controlled by feminist ideological dogma. The Constitution's equitable maxims are written by modern statutes. Rollo Tomasi of Rational Mail did a very relevant article on this topic here, http://2014/01/14/the-second-set-of-books/. Western females, typically Anglosphere in Western Northern Europe, are self-entitled and come from a psychological position of thinking they're better than you are. They believe that shit despite their numerous insecurities because they have been raised to view men as instruments for their desires. They have been told they must be impressed, that a man must wine and dine her, and ultimately the onus is on him to win her heart. She will obsess over her relationship status frantically and doll herself up, but ultimately her part is entirely passive. She comes from a position of superiority and illogically believes she is superior to all but the most high value of men. Part of the red pill is realizing her capacity for brilliance is lower than yours, which brings me on to the next point. Women need men more than men need women. Men generally want sex and perhaps a family so they have a genetic lineage to leave their worldly goods and knowledge to once they die so they may live on through their offspring. However, women need men for their logical minds and stoic consistency, to make her emotionally stable as being the rock in her storm, and also need a partner just to feel complete. Just look at single mother households and all the older women who are single. They are miserable. These women need a man to be happy. Men don't need women to be happy. Men need sex to be happy. A bachelor is not an unhappy guy. A bachelorette is. Women are depreciating assets. Their major asset and unique selling point is their sexual beauty and fertility. Most of them squander their best years on riding the cock carousel, which means fucking lots of different guys in nightclubs, having flings, being generally irresponsible and riding through life on easy mode, getting ahead for no real talent, but because she's pretty and can give head. Women are born. Their ability to conceive children is what makes them women. Men are not born, they are created. Poverty, difficulty, heartache, oppression, pain, these are the things that make men out of boys. This is why you came to TRP. This is why boys come back from the military as men. Conflict and pain is what forges the masculine mindset. Men cannot grow without conflict and learning from their mistakes. Men need to apply their logical minds to problems which arise, elevate, and transcend their previous selves to become more powerful. Men are never born. They are always bred in the bloody fields of battle and war, be it economic, mental or physical. A man is a soldier of differing kinds. A man has learned to repress his fear so he may overcome and achieve. Men take more risks than women and are expected to do so. Being fearful, unconfident and risk-averse as a man leads to failure. You must be confrontational and risk-taking. Single mothers typically breed boys, not men, without outside intervention. Boys do little except play Xbox and eat pizza with no direction in life. They have little luck with girls and end up drinking themselves to dead, smoking pot in their 40s. There's more women in education than men now. Think about that shit for a second. The system has been set up against you. Pull yourself up by the bootstraps. The Red Pill is about pragmatism and truth based on observation. It is not idealistic. In some ways you can say it is liberal. But it is not liberal in the idealistic pseudo-academic sense your institutions have taught you to perceive it as. Liberalism has become corrupted. Liberals today censor and silence opposing opinions. I'm not talking about political parties, I'm talking about ideologically left-leaning people. Their thoughts and ideas are based in idealism, not directly measurable truth. Liberalism has become the religion to pragmatism science. Social market value is everything, something a low-value man says, which is creepy when said by a high-value man, is flirty or sexy. Always be focusing on your physical appearance and make it the best that you can. This will make your life easier in all areas. Not just sexually but financially too, as caused by a phenomenon explored known as the halo effect. Your value is everything, you should always be improving yourself. If you're not, then you cannot compete in the world and your life will be miserable, anesthetized by nothing but the introversion of the four walls you reside in, kept docile by Xbox, porn, pizza and some online friends. Break free of the mediocrity. Your diet and exercise place a certain handicap on your ability to utilize your potential. The obese and those who eat poorly but aren't necessarily fat are typically low energy and thus waste a lot of time unproductively, as they are not in the right mental state to get anything done. You need to take care of your body so then your body will allow your mind to implement its will onto the world. You must be physically active so that you can mentally put your plans into action. Procrastination is the slow-acting poison of one who lives a sedentary lifestyle. Physically active people make things happen in other areas of their life too. Exercise is invigorating. Stop putting it off. Do it. Your body is the temple that houses your mind. Following on from the previous point, higher testosterone will help you increase your abilities and leave you feeling more energetic. Lift. It will give you a rush of energy like nothing else and further increase your T, creating a positive feedback cycle. Jog. Do cardio. A runner's high again is like a drug. You will feel awesome after a jog. Your anxiety goes right down and your confidence rises. Keep it up and the effects stack and become part of your personality.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn. and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.